Hey, movie junkies, welcome back to another episode of Twin Flicks, where we always are celebrating magic of movies and, most importantly, physical media with you. And today is a review I've been anxiously waiting for. We're going to be talking about the master, the father of body horror, David Cronenberg, and his film, Crimes of the Future. Now, first off, Crimes of the Future has been a passion project of his since the early 70s, I believe. He's never been able to get the movie made. No studio wanted to make it. He couldn't find any funding. It was also always planned to be a trilogy of films. But a few years ago, he was able to finally find financing for the film for the first one. As for the sequels, nothing's been said. I guess it's just up in air right now. There's been no announcements for the sequels. I really hope that Cronenberg is able to finish out his trilogy. However, with Crimes of the Future, David Cronenberg did something with this film that he swore he would never do. He took an oath to us fans that he would never, ever shoot any of his films digitally. Oh, Davey, what have you done? What have you done? Betraying film, betraying us film fans by shooting this digitally. However, after watching Crimes of the Future, there is a clear, very specific reason why Cronenberg decided to shoot the film digitally. And I'll get more into that in my review shortly. The film was shot on Arri 4K cameras. And then they created a fully native 4K DI with 10-bit color depth with HDR10 and Dolby Vision grading that was added for both its theatrical run and also both UHD physical presentations here in the States and in the UK. And because of this reason, I chose not to compare between the domestic 4K UHD release and the Second Sight UHD release because they're both sourced from identical digital files, both having the same HDR and Dolby Vision grading. The only difference is the Second Sight edition includes exclusive interviews with cast and crew. Now, obviously, as you can see, I do own the domestic Blu-ray release. However, even the Blu-ray is still sourced from the same native 4K master, just minus the HDR Dolby Vision grading and put on a 1080p Blu-ray disc. So then the question arises, how much better can the UHD actually be compared to the Blu-ray if they're both sourced from the same 4K master? Is it even worth spending the money to upgrade it to your 4K, either the Second Sight or the domestic 4K edition? Well, that's why we're here, so let's dig in and find out. So as I said at the top of this video, David Cronenberg did decide to shoot the film digitally. The reason is because Crimes of the Future is a very specifically very dark-looking film. Cronenberg's intention was to make it very dark, but also fill it with all kinds of visuals. And shooting in high-end, professional-grade 4K cameras really draws out the extra level of details that would otherwise be engulfed in the dark, brooding shadows of the frame. And if you shot it on film, you would lose all of that detail in the image. Now, full disclosure here, I'm not sure how well these images will translate with my review, being that the video is YouTube compressed, and especially if you're watching this on a phone or tablet without HDR. So just keep that in mind. You may not see the full benefit watching on your phone, YouTube, or your tablet. But I will say the biggest improvement here over the Blu-ray with this UHD is the high amount of extra details that are fully visible, down to every little nuance, crack, makeup, and all the practical effects. The 4K just really showcases every aspect of the production design. Even in the darkest, murkiest, brooding corners of the frame with a stunning level of detail here. We have extra lines here with a higher resolution that are razor sharp. Textures are clear and the amount of depth and the three-dimensionality is just extraordinary. This all creates a much more realistic, much more lifelike image from start to finish. And this is something that 1080p Blu-ray just wasn't capable of capturing. That said though, the Blu-ray is no slouch, and it still holds a very good level of detail and depth. But again, the UHD improves on the image, showing us exactly how Cronenberg shot the film in camera with a higher depth and resolution. And this keeps all those details sharply visible, even in the half-lit and dark, dank scenes of the film. Another area that sets this UHD apart from the Blu-ray is taking full advantage of the HDR color grading that really opens up the color gamut with more color depth, tones, and shades. Colors are also slightly warmer than the Blu-ray and have some nice pop to them without looking overly saturated or hot. It's dialed in just right. The HDR grading improves on all the black levels. That's resolved better than the Blu-ray with a truer sense of blacks, especially with night scenes looking more authentic night and low light scenes looking more natural and stable, along with increased shadows and shading that just looks excellent. And all of this really draws out more information in the frame. A good example here is around a 13-minute mark when Mortensen and his girlfriend leave their metal factory. It was shot with a darkening sky behind them, yet every single detail of the crumbling, rusty old home stays perfectly visible behind them, as they are also visible walking in front of the camera. And this is just one example out of many that fully matches the mood and tone of the film perfectly, and also reproduces exactly how the film was shot in camera. And this is just a really nice advantage that the 4K has, especially when you compare it to the Blu-ray. The bitrate ranges from 84, peaking around 97 Mbps, giving a wide, healthy cinematic appearance. Also being shot digitally, there is no grain field, which further explains why Cronenberg decided to shoot digitally. He didn't have to worry about the grain field showing up in the black levels and furthering engulfing the finer details, along with just having the freedom of shooting 4K and the image having more stability than 35mm. I will give one warning, however. This, again, as I have said, this is a very dark-looking film. And the use of HDR does focus on the darker end. This means if you're watching the film in daylight or a brightly lit room, you're just not going to get the same look and impact as you would watching it in a darker room. That's when you're going to find the best results with this UHD. All right, now let's get into the audio presentation of this 4K UHD. And I was really hoping that they would spring for an Atmos mix that was used in the theaters. What we do have is the same DTS 5.1 lossless track as on the Blu-ray. The first thing to note is how beautifully reproduced Howard Shore's score is throughout the film that seeps and oozes out of every discrete channel. Due to the film being more front-end heavy, the surround channels are used sparingly, but when called upon, they kick in with excellent object placement and sounds very nicely balanced, with no sense of overcrowding anywhere in the sound field. The low-end frequency response is just pitch perfect, with excellent spot-on bass response, giving us some nice deep bass cues, and dialogue is rendered perfectly crystal clear. All right, so my score for Second Sight's 4K UHD presentation of Crimes of the Future, I'm giving this one a resounding 5 out of 5. Second Sight keeps knocking it out of the park with each of the 4K UHD releases, and this is absolutely no exception. But now here's the real test. Head over to the comments section and let me know, when you look at the differences here between the Blu-ray and the 4K UHD, which one do you think looks better? Or do you see any comparison at all? Like I said, the Blu-ray is sourced from the same 4K master. Head over to the comments section and let me know. All right, guys, thanks so much for hanging out with me. As always, keep physical media alive, and I'll see you next time.